Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Recombu, and in my hands I have the newly unveiled Honor 7A. So this is following on from last year's 6A. It is the company's new entry-level Android smartphone, and it packs in a surprising amount of premium features, especially when I tell you the price tag, which I'll save for the end. But let's start with what we have in front of us here. So we're looking at a 5.7-inch 18x9 full-view display. So Honor's now bringing that extended aspect ratio, those taller screens that we saw as a big trend starting in 2017, now into the entry level space, which is really nice to see. It's a HD display, so it's not full HD. It's actually 720p by 1440, as I understand it, and it's an LCD panel. You can see there's a bit of brightness drop off here, but again, this is an affordable phone, and head on, the colors actually look really, really nice. It's a pretty solid screen, considering the price point and considering what else is on offer here. There's some bezels, but even those are actually pretty slim. We can forgive that considering this affordable nature of this phone. Up top here as well, we have an 8-megapixel front-facing camera. And one thing that Honor's actually added in is a smart soft light that they're calling it. So I'm gonna jump into the camera just now to show you that. What that actually allows you to do is it's like a selfie light, it's a flashlight, but it actually has multiple levels of brightness and control. So you can have it on auto, you can have it fire off just when you take a standard selfie, and it has two automated modes depending on the surroundings you're in that the phone detects. But it also has three options if you're in manual control too. So you give a lot of control if you like your selfie game, which is nice, and of course there's a beauty mode on there too. Another premium feature that Honor has been keen to bring down to this affordable market is face unlock. So this is actually one of the first affordable phones that we've seen with face unlock functionality. So I'm just gonna tilt it towards me, wake the phone up, and even that, it didn't even have to show me the lock screen. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't, but it takes an impressively short amount of time, about the same speed as an iPhone 10, which is crazy when you're considering this is about a ninth or tenth of the price. But yeah, that's a really nice premium feature to see down at this level. Now, the interface that we're looking at here is Emotion UI. It's version 8.0, so not the latest 8.1 build that we've seen on the likes of the Huawei P20 and P20 Pro, but it is nonetheless a really up-to-date build of Huawei and Honor's own Android overlay, and it's running atop Android 8.0 Oreo 2. So there's no app store out the gate, but you can add that in. There's themes for customization. There's a whole host of apps there that are, some are preloaded from Honor and Huawei. Some of them are just like extra fluff, but you do have the ability to remove those as well, which is nice too. Now let's look at the rest of the device. So if I move around to the edge here, it looks like we have a plastic frame with a metal back based on feel. It's very shiny. This is quite nice though. It still feels good in the hand, and the way it curves around is very natural. The phone is impressively slim. I believe it's 7.8 millimeters. But it feels incredibly light, incredibly thin. Feels really nice in the hand, again, for the price point. You've got some hardware controls on the right here. You've got a volume rocker and a power key. Down the bottom, we have a micro USB port. So it hasn't yet made the jump to Type-C USB. And you've got the speaker and the microphone at the bottom there as well. There is a headphone jack up the top, which you might have spotted. So you do still have that 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. And actually, audio is a big part of this. It has its own PA chip, which offers up to, I think it's 88 decibels when you're using the loudspeaker, so you can pump out sound. There's also gonna be a party mode that they're getting introduced via an OTA update, which actually lets you chain up to 8 different Emotion UI compatible devices and play the same tune across all 8 of them, which is a really smart feature if you're a big fan of Honor and your friends are too. But it's a nice idea, and we've seen it done with Bluetooth speakers, so to have it on a phone as well is quite cool too. The SIM tray in the side here as well, I should also mention, is a 3-in-1 tray, so it actually allows for dual SIM functionality and a micro SD card up to 256 gigabytes. So you have a whole host of flexibility within that, so you can have two networks at the same time. This is a 4G phone, and you can have that micro SD expansion in there too. On the back, as well as face unlock, we have a fingerprint sensor, which of course, being an Honor phone, you do have those gestures, so you can swipe down to get at the notifications pane and all of that good stuff. It feels like a plastic back, so not as premium in terms of materials from the Honor 7C, which the company has announced alongside this phone, but that's probably where most of the money is getting saved. And then up on the back here, we also have a single 13 megapixel rear camera. It has PDAF. It looks like we have a single LED flash there too. And there's multiple microphones as well, so you get, hopefully that means you get stereo recording when you're shooting video. You can shoot up to full HD video, and on the front as well, that counts too. And of course, this is 30 megapixel stills, and then you get 8 megapixel stills on the front. The last thing to mention really is, I guess, performance and price. So on the inside, we're rocking a Qualcomm Snapdragon 430 chipset, 1.8 gigahertz octa-core chip with 2 gigabytes of RAM and 16 gigabytes of internal storage, along with a 3000 milliamp-hour battery. So all in all, a really comprehensive package. For an entry-level device, there's a lot of premium stuff going on here with that face unlock, with that audio experience. There's also a karaoke mode, which we can talk about more in our 7C hands-on, so don't forget to check that out as well. But yeah, this is the Honor 7A. It should be arriving at the end of April for, I believe it is $139.99, which is a really serious price point considering what's available here. If you have any more questions about this phone, you can drop us a line down below in the comments. Don't forget to hit subscribe and hit that bell so you're the first to know when we publish more on this and every other top smartphone on the market. Thanks for watching.